Evil imaginations. So that's why now we need the cross. We need the cross all the time, not only the third week of Lent. We need the cross. We begin here. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and the two natures of Christ. Like this. This is the Orthodox way. Here. We begin here to bless the brain, the mind. And when the brain is healthy, everything will be healthy as well. So, beloved in Christ, this holy canon, one of many canons we have in the church. We have the canon of Akathist service. Akathist in the Greek means we don't sit like as we did. We don't sit. Akathist. Kathisma is like means the chair. The chair, the high chair, or where we sit. So Akathist means like we don't sit. Now, we are not like Pharisees. We are not, you know, like legalistic. We are not, you know, like rigid. If someone like with back pain, for example, if someone like on the wheelchair, if someone like for any reason cannot stand, it's not a blasphemy, it's not a sin. We can sit. But we do as much as we can. Why? The reason behind that, beloved in Christ, on one hand, out of respect to the experience, the church experience, the church practice, and on the other hand, which is more important, is like when the body is tired, the soul, the mind, the whole being is vigilant. Vigilant. So that's why during this holy season, we prostrate a lot. We prostrate, we say, Lord, have mercy million of times, sometimes three times, sometimes 12, sometimes 40. And Lord, have mercy. Without God's mercy, nothing comes. Everything is human, everything is superficial. But when God's mercy is guiding us, that makes like a big difference in our life. If I tell you, and you agree, I am sure, you share the same. If the rest of the life, you know, like Wall Street, New York, Los Angeles, here, Boston, whatever, Syria, Lebanon, Palestine, Iraq, Africa, everywhere, if people will listen to God's mercy and keep it, believe me, we don't need canons, we don't need, you know, like rules, we don't need, you know, governments, maybe we don't need, we will be like in paradise. And this is the whole idea. Now, this land is the tool to bring us back to life in paradise. Like life in paradise is love, is purity, is holiness, is peace, is, you know, like everything. Now we lack that like in our daily life. So this is one of the canons. We have many canons in the church. This like to tell us that, you know, like we are not coming from a vacuum. We as Orthodox, you know, like we've been practicing this for over 2,000 years and came down to us from our Lord himself when he established the church. So the apostles and the holy fathers after that and down to us. So we've been practicing that. So the church is not like just a few pages, we read a few pages and you're like, we shut the doors and we go home. No. So we belong to a history. We belong to a holy history. We belong to some great practice, some great experience in our life. So this is one of many, many canons in the church. We call it, you know, like dedicated, this canon dedicated to the Holy Mother of God. The Holy Theotokos. Why? Why, like, from A to Z, we are praising the same person? Hail, O Bride without wound. Hail this, hail that, hail whatever. So you heard in Arabic and in English. These praises, I am not the one who invented them. These are biblical. You know, like many people say, the Orthodox people do not read the Bible enough. No, this is like a prayer from the Bible. We read the Bible, but we read it in a prayer, with a prayer. We don't just like read it, you know, we cross our legs and we chew it. While we are chewing gum, we read the Bible. No, this is not true. This is not our practice. Our practice, we read and we pray what we read. So that's why we dare to say that the Bible for us is not a book. It's not a book. But it is that person in the book. Means like we communicate with him. We become friends. We become, you know, like a family. We become very, very close to each other. So that's why the Bible is not like what we read. The Bible is the communication with God himself. So this holy season, beloved in Christ, is trying to tell us that we say, you know, like, you can say, oh, what you are saying, Sayyidina, is impossible for a human being, for a normal human being, like Rhode, to do. No, it's not, right? She was a human being like us. She was like a human being like anyone else. The only sinless one is God. Is God. God is the only sinless one. She is full of grace, not by nature, but by grace. You know, like she was the mother like anyone of us. But because of prayer and because of fasting, because of her virtuous life, God himself chosen a human being like her to be his mother. That is very, very high theology. We call it the mystic theology. The mystic theology. Like the theology beyond any logic, any human logic. Human being like us. She went through everything we are going through now. Now, many people do not understand her. Why? Christians, I mean, do not understand her. Why? Because she was a quiet person. She didn't say much. Just a few words in the Bible, the whole Bible, were said by her. But her example was seemed good to God, to him, for him to choose her to be his mother. He didn't choose one from the angels. He didn't choose one from like another planet, for example. He didn't choose, you know, like someone who is supernatural. He chose a human being to be the best example for the entire universe, for the entire world, everywhere, to be carrying this example. So that's why we are praising her according to the Bible, which described her before she was born. That prophecy like, is before, even before her. Before like she came from Joachim and Anna. So what did God, you know, like, want us to understand by this? So all the prophecies about a lady to be his mother, because through her, like Ezekiel, I think the prophet Ezekiel says that gate will be closed forever, and only God will go through that closed door. You know what it means? It means the Holy Virgin. The censer now the priest used. You know what was the censer now? We see like some two pieces with bells around, and that censer means the Holy Theotokos. You know, like her womb, but now her womb had
Jesus in there, like a charcoal.
Like a fire. Like a fire. Now, the ark, you know, like when Noah saw the, or was saved from drowning, so the ark, you know, like was a holy virgin. Another, you know, like one from the Bible, from the prophecies, like Jacob when he saw the ladder from heaven down to earth, and the angels of God up and down, and she is the bridge from earth to heaven. So through her, all of us will be saved. So when we are praising that Holy Virgin a lot, like in our daily life in the Middle East, like we say Yahadra all the time. So we mention like the name of the Holy Virgin more than anything else, and that is not a blasphemy. That is not a mistake. That is not a sin. That is a blessing. So that's why we say every liturgy, and especially Sundays, we say through the intercessions or the prayers of the Holy Theotokos, O Savior, save us. So now when we say Most Holy Theotokos, save us, God is saving that people, not her. Her like, role is to intercede for us because she is a mother, like at home when we were kids, and now like everything, now when we need something, we rush like toward our moms, you know, like not before, you know, like not toward our fathers, you know, like our fathers busy, and sometimes, you know, like they lose their temper very quickly, but the mothers, you know, like they have a lot of patience because God made them this way. So the mother, the intercessions and the prayer of the Holy Theotokos counts much according like in the eyes of God. So beloved in Christ, like the prayer tonight is extremely important. You don't know how much God is gonna appreciate this prayer for our salvation and for the people who are not in the church as well. Because like every time we gather in the church, we pray for our salvation first, but we pray for every human being. We pray for the people in Africa. We pray for the people in Iraq. We pray for the people here in this nation. We pray for the people everywhere in this. This is our responsibility. Like the Archdiocese, now we have almost 300 churches, but in the 300 churches, we are praying for the entire world. So, beloved in Christ, this prayer is for you, for me, for everyone. It gives us a joy. It gives us like hope that God is not gonna abandon any one of us, because every one of us, those who are present here and those who are on the road, those who are traveling, those who are in business, those who are lazy, if you like, they are mentioned in the church, in the prayer. And this prayer is for every human being, for the salvation and for the joy and for the blessing of every human being. So this service is very old, was ordained, as we were talking this afternoon, was ordained, was decided, was, you know, invented, if you like, by holy people. And now we are enjoying using their fruits, the fruits of their experience, the fruits of their love for God, and the fruits of like their care for all humanity. So that's why, you know, like, now, in addition to our, like, everyone's prayer, we have her intercessions. That is the guarantee for all of us. So now,
all the metaphors, all the beautiful pictures, all the beautiful icons. You know, like this service,
if you go to
all monasteries in Greece or somewhere else, you see from A to Z what we heard tonight on icons. You don't hear like words or music, but you see the whole Akathist service in icons around, you know, like that monster. It's extremely beautiful. It's extremely beautiful. So I pray, beloved in Christ, I pray that your time, the remaining time of fast, will be very beneficial and very fruitful. You know, for you, for your children and grandchildren, for everyone in your life, those who are present here, those who are overseas, those who are, you know, like everywhere, maybe. So our obligation to pray, to include them in our prayer. So may the mercy of God, may the mercy of God guide us to take, if we haven't done it like the right way from day one until now, God is not counting how many days. God is not counting like a teacher, like a professor in a college or in a school. So God is the Father of all. So that's why, you know, God desires first and foremost, like everyone, to be saved. He doesn't care, you know, like whether you are sitting in the first pew or somewhere else. No. God is looking for our mind, soul, and body. So our respect for this holy lady, the Virgin Mary, because she was virtuous in mind, soul, and body. So everyone will emulate that example. Everyone will take that example seriously in his life, he will be saved. She will be saved, or all of us will be saved like her. So God will never forget anyone of us. Beloved in Christ, the spiritual diseases in the 21st century are numberless. A moment like this, to be together here, not to please the Metropolitan, not to please the bishop, not to please the priest, not to please you are X, Y, Z. No, you are here because of you are coming here to make some room in your life for God to work in you. That is the Orthodox prayer. That is the life of prayer. You know, some churches, they are fighting over money, over building, over iconography. One day in California, when I was still in California, they were fighting over what color they have to paint the cup of the church. You know, and the priest said, "Let us call Sayyidina," and I was in bed. And the president, the parish president, you know, like, it happened that she was a woman, and I am very close to that family. And she starts on the phone arguing with me about what color. So I said, you know, like innocently, I said, before iconography, the best color like to the church to be painted like Swiss coffee, like means, like not white, you know, like completely, but it is like yellowish, gold, beige, ivory, something like that, like to be bright, in order when they have money and they have like the means like to start like working on their iconography, so it is easy like to do that. And she started arguing with me. I said, "Why are you calling me if you don't have to listen? You don't listen." So people are fighting over this and that. Believe me, it's not worth it. The church is not about the parish council. The church is not about the color. The church is more deeper than that. And we have to go to that depth. Otherwise, if we don't go into that depth, we remain on the surface and we become very superficial. So, beloved in Christ, this holy season to help us to be deep, to dig very deeply, to be part of that theology which happened for our salvation. And if we miss this, God forbid, we miss everything beloved in Christ. We hear like now we're talking in that car coming here. Many people, they have the money, they are unhappy. Some people without money, they are unhappy. Some people, you know, like when they are sick, they are unhappy or happy, whatever. So we have many excuses. But the church, you know, gives us a vision. Where to go from here? Death in our life, God forbid, is not the end of the road. That is the beginning of another chapter of our life. So many people, God, are afraid of death. You know why? Because they are afraid to lose it. They are afraid to lose control, to lose money, to lose possession, to lose, you know, anything in this life. But believe me, which is more important, this or the kingdom of God? To have some very glory now and the people to praise me, you know, like people say, you are the best and whatever for like one day or two and whatever, and I miss the most important thing. You see, we don't have to fear. We have one kind of fear in our life. Either fear of sin, and that is very legitimate, or we have another good kind of fear, that is fear of God. That the utmost love, that the most important level of love, we call it like in our daily life, we call it the explosive love. Like when he went onto the cross for our salvation, that is the utmost level of, the highest level of love. When you sacrifice all your life for the people whom you love. But first of all, we love ourselves. Okay, that's sacrifice for ourselves. We love the people around us. That is sacrifice for our people around us. So I pray that until I see you again, God willing, I pray that your remaining of the fast will go very godly. Will be done in godliness. In godliness. It's not about zakah or about giving or about this or that. Keep your mind pure. Your mind was pure. Keep your heart not to leave any room for the evil one or for any evil in your action. Keep the room in your heart only for God and for reconciliation. At that time you will have all the peace you need, you are looking for. So until we see each other, God willing, I wish you and I pray that the Sunday of the cross will be like courageous more and more, and to be victorious because of the cross. The victory of the cross, and at that time, you know, like when Pascha comes, when we say in this church, with everyone, Christ is risen, that is like beyond and above any human need, any earthly thinking, anything in this life. Because Pascha, nothing is like it at all. Nothing. So again, it's a joy to be visiting you here. I know some of you. I want like a chance, the opportunity to know the rest, to know all of you, and may God keep you blessed.